See, basically, when we are, when, anyways, any company, any organization, whatever the organization you're looking for, so basically, organizations, what they look into is they have to generate reports, right? Generate reports so that they can see where the organization stands now, or how the work, I mean, how the workers in the, or employees in that particular organizations are working, how many employees are working, how many are certified, or how many people are in this grade, in that grade. So there are so many reports, right? They want to showcase that, right? And also, whenever we see about profits, we need quarter one, quarter two, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 results, right? So that will tell us where we stand in the market. So basically, whatever you want to know, what you do is you have to generate reports. For example, from you, we are, ours is an e-commerce application, so we need to pull down all the report of how many products have been, say, sold in this particular day, today, or else it could be previous 3 months, or it could be last 6 months, last month. So everything is a, it's like a report to you, right? So one report might be used for the business people, for the organization where it talks about profits and loss, and one report may be tell you about where the exactly the processor, like for example, pull down a report about how many products are dispatched, or how many processed have been are in the in transit. See, these all things. And next one is you may also look into like how much profit you gain in this today. So there are two different. One is talking about profit and one is talking about the process where it is. Whenever you say a report is divided into two ways. One is business report and next one is process. When do you say it as a business report? You say a business report when it uses business metrics. What are business metrics? Business metrics like profits, how many sales have been done this year, last year, comparison, comparing from one department to another department. This department has given this much of money. What about that department? What I can do for it? See, for example, there are two departments. Loan department is there, and home loan department is there, and education loan department is there. Home loan department has got so much of profit, but education department has got less profit. Then what you do, this is what report is giving, and based on this report, what you'll do is you will take some, you will recruit sales people for education loan department and make them educated, and means you give some trainings to them, and then you will send it to all across the places to take the loans for education. So in that way you will grow your education loan department. So based upon that, if you are going to create a report, then you call it as a business report. Or else, like you may also drill down a report, I mean, pull down a report where you will say that one particular, some there are some 30 or 40 products which are lost in transit. We don't know in which place they are. Not know which place they are. So that is also a problem to us, right or not? All right. So this particular is talking about a
Which one?
process. So it talks about process. So in this way, we divide a business metric and process metric. So whenever it takes a process metrics, we call it as process report. Whenever we take a business metric, we say it as a business report. Generally, who will use reports? Whether it is end user or of course end user. In the end user, all the end users will see the reports, or only few people will be using the report. Means mostly few people will be using these reports. Not all will be using. For example, if I take a bank example, all the clerks, will they use reports? Means no, they may not use reports. They don't want reports at all. But the manager who is working there, he needs report. Yeah, so that is where we are talking. Like mostly these reports are for the managers so that they will take the data and analyze the data and get the solution for that particular report. They can take some necessary action on it. So these reports will help us the progress of our application or progress of the company, like progress of some project, of that particular project. Yes or no? A report definition rule. How many report, I mean, how to use this report definition? A report definition rule is used to retrieve data from the database. What reports it will show us? Let's go to this DevStudio. So reports comes under report rule category. So let us create one report to the accidental claim. Okay? So let's create, we'll see this particular label, this particular report is to see how many cases are resolved, resolved claims. Yeah. So click on create and open. So your manager want to see how many claims have been resolved by this time. So right. So this is how your report definition rule looks like. Okay. So whatever the columns you want to write, that you write in the query tab. Okay. So next, here it is columns. What is this? Is whatever the columns you want to show to the user. Okay. Show to the user. For example, your manager want to show you see the resolved cases. Yes or no? That means he want case ID. He want the status. And what is the application name? Application. For example, if it is a person, you have given already names to each and every. Then you could have seen the application name also, right? Applicant name. Manager want who is the applicant and what is his case ID and whether the cases. He want to see only the cases which has been resolved, or he want to see what are all the cases created. For that, case ID is available in the PY ID. We have already said, right? And next, right here, we want name, right? Applicant details name. It won't show, I think. Yeah. Applicant details. Yeah, right. Details dot name. Okay. And we want to see the status of that particular PY status work. Can you see here? Right. If you observe, PY ID, PY status work are coming, but this applicant dot name was not coming. We'll come to that later. Okay. Right. So that is save. How many cases are there which are created by the Pega? Means in Pega. Yeah. So see, these are all so many cases. Cases have been resolved. Now I can ask them why these many records are not resolved. Now I have a clear vision now. How many cases are there and how many have been resolved or how many not been resolved. But I want only cases which are resolved to be shown. So how do you do that? In report definition, we have filter also. So in the edit columns, whatever the columns you want to show to the user, you will use those columns. We have so many columns to be added, but we don't want everything. We want only three things in it. One is what is the case ID, who is the name, who is the applicant for that case ID, and what is the status of that particular case ID. Still you want something like his mobile number also, then we can add his mobile number also. Still you want email ID, then you can also even add email ID. It's up to you what you want to add. The condition is like this. What is the condition now? I want to see only resolved ones. But if I created this report definition, I am able to see resolved ones and unresolved ones also. There is no condition because all reports are coming. But manager was saying that I want a report which generates only resolved ones. Then there comes a condition. Yes, condition is resolved ones. So how do you write conditions? Where do you write conditions? Means in the report definition, you have something called as edit filters where conditions are written. So here in the as you have written in the column source, you need to write dot PY status work is equal to what do you want? So in the selected values, you have to select that. What do you want? Resolved completed ones. Submit. Save. Now you run this case. See how many have come now to you. Only two records are there which are resolved completed. Now what we do is we'll create a new case. Collect address details. Okay, after that it should go to accidental claim. Can you see now it is resolved completed, right?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
What is the case? Right. Now we'll go and we'll do this. Refresh, action, run. So why I asked you to do is to check whether it is showing you this result completely. Yeah. So this is how you you create a report definition in an application. Okay. So now the same report definition, you need to show it to the manager also. But if it is Dev Studio, will manager log into the Dev Studio? Where he will log in? Manager is an end user. So we make Chandu as manager here. So let's write Chandu here. Chandu is the manager. So now we need to make him as manager. So add an access group. Okay, he is a manager now. Let's log off. So he is the manager for that particular application. So if you see, a manager can create a case ID. He can also create a case ID. Let's create a case. We just created, we did nothing. We logged into the Chandu's portal and we asked him to create two cases and we asked to resolve the cases. Okay. Okay. He's created another case, but he's not completing it. Okay. Let's go to dashboard. So this is his dashboard. This dashboard shows who are the team members and all those things here. We are not worried about this also. And click on my work. My work gives the work list where Chandu has to complete certain tasks. Next is my teams. My teams is who are all involved, means who are all his team members. You can see that. So he got only one team. He can also create a team and add all the members into it. Next, you can see reports. So only manager has this ability to see the reports. So this is what he can see, the reports which are there here, but as of now no reports were there for him, but he can see all the reports. What do you mean by my reports? Means my reports is the private kind of thing. That means for his purpose he might be creating certain reports and those reports will be available in this category.
Okay.
And coming to all reports is for everyone. It is for the global one. It's a public one where all reports can be seen there. Okay, so these are all the reports which are by default given by Pega. The question is, where is our report which we created in the at dev portal? That is not there in this particular manager portal. Whatever the report definition you created in your dev portal, those report definition will not be available to manager until and unless you do certain change. That I will be telling what we should do so that report will be shown into the manager portal. Okay, right. Okay, so that is the one part. So keep that aside. So two things I ask you to remember. One is, whenever we are configuring applicant dot name in the report definition, it is not showing to us. Means it is not showing the in the down arrow, right? That is one thing which I ask you to remember. And second one is, another one I'm asking you to remember is, we have created a report definition, but that report definition rule is not available in Pega, in manager. So two things. Yeah. So now we are going to the third one. Third one is this one. So when you look into the manager portal, a manager portal has a reports menu, and when you click into the reports menu, he has two things. One is my report and next one is all reports. So my report will have the reports created by this particular manager, and all reports will have the all reports which are given by which are shown to the public. So there are two types of there are two types of reports here, two types of categories here, not reports, two types of categories here. One is my report category, next one is all report category. If you see, can you see in category we got all report. So in that, see, these are all different categories in it. Let me go to my report. So my report has nothing. You have not yet created a report. Try creating a new report. So it is asking us to create a new report. Okay. So coming to the all reports, if you see, some reports are already given us, right? If you look into this, there are certain types. Here it is showing list. Here it is showing summary, and here it is showing some charts. Can you see diagram, chart diagrams, pie chart? This is bar chart diagrams. These are all. This is also bar. This vertical bars and these are all horizontal bars. But here it is not like that. Means reports are of types here. Be a list summary, a list report, or summary report. My next is chart reports also. So let us open this chart and see what it is showing. So I clicked on that. I'm just seeing what actually it is showing. Nothing is there. This till now there is nothing. No, nothing is shown here. That's why it is showing no data. It is showing here. like we have seen certain types, right? So now what we do is we will see how to create a report in manager portal. There is something called as new report. How many categories we have? One is my report category, next is all reports category, right? We can create a prop, we can create a new report also. Yes.
Okay.
So click on new report. So it will ask what is a case, what is their new report, from which case type you want, from which layer you want. So you want it from the accidental claim. Whenever I say claims case layer, then it is work class application. See, how is your application looking like? United hyphen claims hyphen work hyphen case type accidental claim, right? So it is work class. Okay, so now I'll go for accidental claim. What type of report can you see here? Report type is of list or summary or chat. What do you want? So let me go for list. Submit. It is going to create a report for us. But is this same looks like dev portal means? No, it doesn't look like dev portal. Okay. Now, what do you want in this report? What do you want? Can you see here? It already had label. It already had case ID. It already had entered on, it already had case status. Do you want these all things? By default, Pega gives you label, case ID, entered on, case status. You want label, what you do? Just click on this arrow and delete. Are you sure you want to delete the column? Yes. In the same way, you don't want entered on. Why do you want it when it is entered and all? Okay. Delete. He want to see who created this. But how to add column here? So to add a column, you have a data explorer here. So in the data explorer, your data explorer divided into three tabs: best bets, all matches, calculations.
Okay.
So in the best bets, it gives you the best columns which you can use for your report. Column in the sense, what are all related to this particular case type. Like, can you see any children? Any children? Any, can you see customer name? So these are all are to that particular accidental claim. And all matches gives you entire application properties. Can you see acknowledgement time, age from date, application name, case ID, contact type, create operator. See how many it has given. Do you need all these things first? And you need to, you do you want to find out it? Search for what you want and all these things? It will be very difficult for us. So that's why they gave best bets, where it gives you the most suitable properties which you can use for this particular report. And all matches will have all the properties. And calculations will have the, you know, like whatever functions you want to add. Do you want to add certain functions? You want to convert date time to text? You don't want to convert date, concatenate any two properties. These type of functions you'll have in the calculations. So now we will use best bets. So in the best bets, what I want is who created the operator, who created that case I want. So that will give us this one only, right? Operator name only will give us, right? Or create operator will give anything. This can be given or that can be given, right? So what I do is create operator name. I'll drag and so you can drop like this. Whenever you drop, can you see the right tick mark is coming? And that too, where do you want to drop? Whether you want it as a second column, first column or third column? Can you see? So I want it as a third column. Yeah. Can you see now? Yes. I'll just. So when I drop there, can you see operator name? But somewhere you will see Chandu also. Right, so in that way you add it and you'll click on done editing. So whenever you say done editing, then it will show you categories. Can you see how many categories you have? Private and public. So whenever a manager want to create a report definition, so if you want to create a report, then he can create a report in his category, that is private category, or in public category. If it is private, then he himself can see that particular report. No one can view that report. If it is public, then everyone, whoever the managers are there in that particular application, can view that report. So what we want, whether we want to create it as a private or a public, my private, my reports, that is only for him. Click on submit. Claim cases or anything, yeah. Created by. Right, done editing. Okay, so this is your report called as cases created by, and you can see all the cases created by. Now, if you go to reports, where do you see this report? In my reports or all categories? In my reports, there is one now. And that too, you can see that as a list because we created it as a list. Yes or no? How does a list shows to you? Tables and columns, right? As a list. If you want to edit this report, again, click on this edit report. Okay? You want report, you want this report as how many cases are created by Shafi and how many cases are created by Chandu. Because if you click on this done editing, it is simply showing the records, 35 records, but it is not showing how many done by Chandu and how many done by Shafi, right? You have account, you will go to actions and you will click on summarize. So summarize will summarize the data. So what do you want? Which one you want? You want cases ID, case group by or count? You want count. And next, apply changes. Done editing. If you now see, can you see there? I made it for the case IDs, yes. So how many it is showing? 35 cases are there. In that, 30 are new cases and 30 are new and 5 are resolved. And again, I will go for action and summarize. I made both here. Can you see now? Chandu, how many cases created, and this one. Okay, so what I did, I went to action, summarize. I made include a column of row counts, expand all group section by default and initial display. I made it. So I made case ID in case status as count and count. Okay, in the operator, so we made this count, right? In the case ID, there are 35 cases. In that, Chandu created 3 and Shafi created 32. So okay. This way we have to do these things, but this all can be done in the manager portal itself. Understood? So we call this as report browser. Yeah, in the report browser we need to modify the, and we can also have a filter here. Can you see filter? If you want to add any filter here, like you can even add a filter. So you can just drop here. So create operator. I dropped one column. So which one? I added create operator. So I'll select values. Oh, so many are there. So I'll say only Chandu. Submit. Apply changes. Okay, can you see now only Chandu's case IDs are coming now. So this is how, you drop, you do the filter. Can you see, filter is also there in our report definition. If you compare there, in the even report definition rule also have this.
Yeah.
Yes. I want this report into summarized report. Already this is summarized only, because in a summarized report only we have to gather all the rows and make it one row. Can you see now? Before that it was showing three separate records, but now it is showing only single record as 3. Yes, so we summarized it. Okay, now let me go to action. Okay, and make it as list. I don't know, I'm doing this. See the changes here. You have change logic, you have add chart, you have these all things. Add chart is very important. I'm just changing into list. So let me change into list. Can you see there something is missing here? Exactly. Right? So add chart means summary. That's why they have given as what? Summarize or chart. Summarize or chart they have given, right? So if you want to create a chart, then you need, your report should be a summarized report. Okay? So now you can see, I mean added label and all those things. So now you can see add chart. So click on chart. So what chart you want to create? Pie chart, what else you want? You can select from here. So let us take pie chart example. So it should be shown. It should be exploded one. So in this, you have to drop the aggregate columns. Okay, so case ID is our aggregate column. Can you see right tick mark is coming, right? Let me drag label. Can you see nothing is shown here label for label because it's not an aggregate.
Mm-hmm.
But if I drag case ID, can you see tick mark will come?
Yeah,
so drag that. So in drop by column is there, drop group by column. So group by column is create operator ID. Can I drop? So based on the operator IDs, we need to see the case IDs. But our okay, so let me apply changes. Apply changes. But what was our filter here? It is only Chendu's, right? So let's delete this.
Okay.
So now see, this is Chendu's and most of them were created by Sheffy only.
Okay.
91% of things were created by Sheffy, but only some 8.5 were done by Chendu. Yes.
Okay.
If you want to change this, edit chart. Okay, so let me go to this and change this to this one, a clustered one. Okay, can you see now Chendu this much and Sheffy out almost 32 cases. Case ID is this side. So how many case IDs are there? 32 case IDs are there. And down it is operator ID. So we have something else also, right? Case status also, right? I'm just deleting all. I'm seeing whether I can drop operator name. I think case ID is our case ID, right? Okay. Operator name. Okay. Status. Okay. Case ID already took because case ID here and next case status will take. Okay, this is group by. I'll take case status in between this. Okay, so what is what I'm doing is how Chendu has created. Okay, how many Chendu created and how many has got resolved, that I'm also checking. Okay, see here, yeah, case IDs and case statuses. Can you see case statuses is this one, right?
Yeah,
so case status, can you see case ID 32, case statuses are also there. Submit. Apply changes. And if you see here, only one case is there which is new, and there are some 29 cases which are new. Yes or no? So let's log off and log in with the dev portal. No, understood, manager portal, right?
Yeah.
So we'll go to report viewer. So we'll go to report viewer and click on display, and we'll make keep it as an open process. Save. See, it's saved now, right? So it is saved in what? In the open cases and our, and it was sort of resolved claims. Okay, so let me log off. Can you log in with Yachidu? Go to, where do you want to go? Reports. Yeah, so now in which category it will be there? See, in all reports you have to select here and you have open cases, right? On these open cases. Now you see resolved claims. So you got it now from where this has been given? From the dev portal to the manager. So that means managers, whenever there is an application being created, the business stakeholders will say that these are the reports we want, and these are the reports which have to be given by the manager to the manager. So what we do is we'll just say that what are the reports we want to create, that reports we'll make it in, we'll add it into the manager's portal. So how do you do that is you'll go to the report definition. In that you have certain tab called as report viewer, click on that. And in the right side, the first selection box will be there. And that is what selection box tells you about was display in report browser. So that will give you this particular particular thing. Okay, got it? So how did you do? Again, we'll go there. Log off. Again with Shafi. We have gone to report viewer tab. And in this, we selected display in this one. Okay. Now tell me whether this is a list or summarized. Yeah, how do you make summarized? Can you see there you have summarize up here, summarize?
Yeah.
So you'll select here. What do you want to select here? Do you want PYID summarize? Make it as count and save. And now you see action run. Summarized it, yes?
Mm-hmm.
So James is 1, Peter is 1, Rashafi is 3, which are resolved completed, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right, and we'll make again this as blank. Okay, save. And how do you do chat? We'll go here. Can you see nothing is shown here? Yes, because it is a list. So what we do, we'll make this as again count. That is summarize, save. Now go to chat. Can you see include chat? What do you want to add? We'll take this. Now save. Action. Run. So you'll see a speedometer. Okay. It is showing all cases resolved. Right? Chat action. If you want to save this image, you can save the image. So I'll take the same one, explored one. Action. Run. You got it?
Yeah.
So many cases by Shafi, few cases by with the name Peter, and few cases are with the name. We took applicant.name, right? So that's why you're getting.
Yeah.
So you added only James 1, Peter 1, Shafi so many. So like that. Now what you want to do is you want to use this report definition in your case.
Okay.
So how do you use that? Okay. Go to App Explorer. So you want to use in the case, right? So let's create one step. Okay, collect. So we are right. Report on resolved cases. Okay.
Okay.
So let's go to section. How to go to section? Click on the process. Open process. Our flow action will be here, right?
Okay.
So on this flow action, we have section rule, yes?
Mm-hmm.
But as we didn't create anything, have we configured view there?
No.
So that's why they didn't create any flow action for us. Okay?
Okay, yeah.
So what we are doing now, we will create now. Manually we are creating. Okay, so let's create. So whenever we create it, it will ask you the section name. Do you see section is empty now? What we do?
Yeah.
We'll create a section. It won't show any error because so click on create and open. Now a section is create shown to you. Yes. Then what I want to add, I said I want to add a label. So click on plus. We'll see any label is there.
Label.
You see label is there? So that label is showing as sample text. But what we show? We'll say it as reports. We'll write value as resolved cases report. Submit. Okay. And next we'll add chart. Can you see a chart? So let's create. Click on the chart. So when you click on the chart, Okay. So from where it is coming from? Report definition. Yeah. So applies to class. You right? United hyphen. Yeah. What is the rule definition? So what is the name in x-axis? Case status. What is the multiple or single you want? If you want multiple, you can add it. So you want multiple? Yes. On y-axis, what do you want? You want name or you want here case status? Yeah, that's fine. That's showing awesome. Okay. We didn't give chart title actually. So you can give chart title as resolved cases. Yeah, submit. So we don't want this, right? We don't want this, yeah. Right? So we saved section. Okay, next, what we need to save? We need to save flow action. We need to save flow. And we need to save
case
type. Why it is in stain? Because we change the flow. Save. Can you save and run this? Okay. So you added the report definition into your case. Yes?
Okay.
This is like chart. You added as a chart. You can also add as a list also. That's up to you.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we did two things. One is how to add into the manager portal I shown you. And how do you add charts into the case I have shown you. And I also shown you report browser where you have two types of categories. My report category, all category. Where my reports is a public private category and all reports is the public category. And I also have shown you how do you add filters to the report, right? And also we have seen summarized report. Okay. We'll also see group by report. Group by. So you group all the things and keep it as one column. So how do you do that? So this is query chart. This is query tab. This is chart tab. And this is report viewer tab. In the report viewer tab, if you see here, there is something called as grouping. Yeah, see the changes here. I'll go to query now. I'll go to query and I make this as blank. And then I'll go to report viewer. See, something has changed here. Okay, so I'll again go back to query. I make this as summarized. And we'll go to report viewer and see this grouping. Can you see? What did you understand now? A report is summarized, then you cannot group the report. If I make it as list and then in the report here you can see group results. Grouping cannot be done for a summarized report. Chart cannot be done for a list report. Charts can be done only for summarized reports and grouping is done only for the list report. So let's click on group result. So how many groups you want to add? So you want to add, can you please change that 1 to 2? Yeah. What do you mean by this? Means you are making two columns as one heading and showing to the user. Let's see the output now. Can you see now? Name and case status became one column. Case ID is another column. Yes. Understood now?
Yeah.
Before, case ID was one column, name is one column, status is one column. But what you are doing now, you made it as group. Whenever you grouped, so it became like that. So what you group? How did you know that name and status, case status have been grouped? Okay, so here if you see here, there is a 1 and 2, right? That means column number 1 and the column number 2 will be grouped. So let's go to query tab and see. Can you see here, column number 1 is applicant details name and column number 2 is PYS. Don't think that the order is like this, 1, 2, 3. You have to see the sort order. Can you see column number is 1 and column number 2? So if I'll make this as 1. make this as 3. Right, let's save this. So now if you see the action and run, if you see the output, then PY ID and PY status work should be the one column. Can you see now? PY ID and case status is one column, but name is another column now.
Okay.
Got it about grouping? So you do grouping based upon the sort order. It's not simply you think, don't think that column 1, column 2, column 3 will be grouped. No, based upon the sort order, it will do. So now understood sort. So there is something called as sort type. Sort type means ascending order and descending order. So let me make applicant name as highest to lowest. Then what happens? Shefi should come first. Then last, James should come last. Can you see now Shefi has come first and James came last. Okay. So it is, if it is highest to lowest, then it is descending order.
Okay.
Highest to lowest. It is descending. So Z comes first, highest to lowest. Then, you know, Y, then X, then, you know, like that. If it is date, then it starts from today's date to last date. I mean, to previous month date, if it is like that. If it is lowest to highest, then from last month to this month. So it is lowest to highest and highest to lowest, right? So almost all of them covered and one is miss, one is not covered. What is that? What is that is, yeah, whenever I want to add a column dot applicant details, dot applicant details, it's not showing to me. It is showing all PY, PX, PZs.
Yeah.
Why it is not showing? Basically, whenever you create a case, all the case related data is stored in only one column.
Okay.
Okay. Whenever you create a case data is huge, right?
Yeah.
If you look into this particular case, it is having chart also. It should also save that image in the database. Yes. In that way, so many cases are there, and for each and every case, do you think that for accidental claim there will be a data, there will be a table, and bodily injury there will be a table? Means no. For all case types, you have only one table. For each and every case type, you don't have separate tables. Okay. So how do you see that? So go to this accidental claim. Right click on that. And see definition. Again, definition. Okay. What is the claim to which data, which table it has connected? Can I click on text connection? Yeah. If I click on text connection, can you see it is mapped to PC underscore United underscore work? Right. So now I'll go to this bodily injury. This is bodily injury, right? So let's click on test connection. See where it is stored again, same